Hey YouTube, my name is Dan and this is a short free extract of my longer course called Animated Infographics and Data Visualization. That course, along with the free exercise files for this particular video and a free downloadable cheat sheet, can be found at bringyourownlaptop.com. There. In this video, we're going to bring in some audio, we're going to put it into some folders, we're going to bring in some music and look out where to get some of that for free. And then we're going to balance it so that my voice isn't so low and the music is down a bit so you can hear it underneath me. Let's hit it. The value of sleep for creatives. It's made me sound a little more like I know what I'm doing. Anyway, let's get on with the course, which I do know what I'm doing with most of the time. Okay, let's deal with audio properly in this video. So we're dealing with a voiceover. It's me. Okay, if you're doing your own voiceover, it makes it easy. If you've got a half decent mic, it's pretty easy to do. But probably you're going to be like most people and hate the sound of your own voice, me included. Okay, but it was cheaper to do my own voiceover than paying somebody else for this exercise, so you got stuck with me. If you do want to hire talent, okay, what I do is I go out to a site like Fiverr. So Fiverr is a site you're meant to pay $5 or euros where I am. Okay, and it's what people will do for $5. This guy will do a voiceover here for $5. That's the euro translation, okay, or the currency exchange. And if you click play, you can listen to Todd. Him. Hello, Fiverr fans. My name is Todd. Hello, Todd. Great. So he'll do that for $5, a certain amount of words. Okay. So it seems cheap, but bank on it being about $25 to $50, depending, because he'll might say, I'll do the first, the first 50 words for $5 or the first 10 words, whatever his rates are. Okay. And you might have to go further than that. And if you want it done, like he'll say it's $5, but I'll do it when I get around to it. Okay. Maybe a week. Or if you want it done straight away, you might have to pay another $10. So it kind of adds up. And by adding up, $25 is pretty cheap for a voiceover. Okay, so just have a go through and just say, do I need a Caribbean voiceover? Or do I need this guy? Or that guy? He has a great, like, normal voice. Okay, if you need somebody who's Irish, if you need somebody who's Australian or English, just type it in up here. Okay, I just typed in voiceover to get these guys, and it's amazing what you can get done quite quickly and cheaply. All right, so we've got our voiceover. Back to After Effects. So when you are working with audio, especially a voiceover, often you need to time things to it. You can see I've added little markers down here. We'll look at these markers a little bit later on. I've added them here, so at this early stage, we can add our infographics at different timing points. But if you need to edit audio, what you really need to do is something on Audition. It's down here. Okay, so I recorded it into Audition and did any edits. So I cut out all the ums and ahs and made it sound half decent. Okay, in Audition, if you need to remove background noises, the air conditioning noise, something like that, that's the job for Audition. And I'll do a course about that real soon. Okay, so we've got our MP3, it's come through. And one of the things you might want to do is see, I can twirl down this little arrow here and go to waveform. Waveform is really handy. You can start to see where the breaks in the language are. You can see I paused there for a little bit. So you can kind of start timing things, like I'm probably starting to say something about here. I'm gonna hit spacebar. You can see I've got the beginning of a conversation there. I often have this open when I'm trying to time infographics to an audio file like this. I'm gonna twirl it up at the moment. Now, one of the big things is you wouldn't have seen I had that open already, but when I hit the play for this, it's quite quiet, okay? And you don't really notice it when you're working in your projects. You need to check whenever you bring in audio to check whether it's at the right level. You don't want to send your infographic somewhere, okay, and people be listening to it and it either blow their eardrums out or just be really, really low and they raise the volume, okay, and then the next video blows their eardrums out. So you want to get consistent. There's a world consistency sound, okay, and it's between -6 and -12. Yeah, minus is weird, huh? Decibels work from 0 being the highest, okay, and you work down from that. How to check? It's quite easy. Go to Window, okay, go down to Audio, okay, or in my case, there was that little gap there. And this little guy is what we're going to be watching for. And see the gap between -6 and about -12? You want, if I hit spacebar, watch it. See it bouncing down here? Okay, it's bouncing too low. Okay, you want it to be bouncing, that little line to be bouncing anywhere between here and here's a good, kind of general range. Any higher than that, see, red, bad. Okay, yellow, just okay. But in here's the sweet zone. And all you need to do is have it selected. Okay, what you might have to do is, if you've got it locked, like the last video, is unlock it, select it, and just yank it up a bit, and then see how it goes. Hit spacebar. Not bad. I'm going to get a little bit higher. Yeah, it's bouncing in that right kind of sweet zone you can see there. It's never perfect. Okay, but that's going to be great for me. Okay, next thing is let's bring in the rest of the audio. We can go to File, Import, File. Okay, it's a long way. There's a shortcut, Command-I on a Mac or Control-I on a PC. You'll use that loads. To be honest, I'd never use it. I just double-click in this big gray area here in my project window. So just double-click. That's the shortcut to it. I find it quite quick anyway. So there's two files. Go to your exercise files. Okay, and under Icon Pop, okay, 01 Icon Pop, bring in Blop, okay, .mp3. And double-click it again. Let's bring in a second file. It's just under the root infographic exercise files. It's called background music. Okay, we're going to use these on all the different exercises we do, so hey ho, it's in its own folder. And all of these files here, they're a mixture of free because somebody like Wistia have given them out to us. So Wistia is Wista. Go check out them. They've got some free background music that I saw the other day and I appropriated for some of my projects. The other ones in here, okay, are from Shutterstock. Okay, so it's a stock music site. Okay, and I've paid for them. Well, actually, these ones are the preview version. So what you'll notice is that you'll play it for a little while and it plays all happy music. But then part of the way through, it says Shutterstock music. Okay, so to kind of ruin the MP3 for you so that you go off and pay for it. Okay, so you're not allowed to use these commercially, okay, any of the Shutterstock ones, but you can kind of see here, this one here is the Wistia Learning Gallery, okay, and they allow you to use it for commercial purposes. So I'm going to use Interlaken Crossroad. At this stage, follow me. You can pick a different one, of course, but I've done this project, obviously, and try to find something appropriate, but hey-ho. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add it to my comp. You can do it a couple of ways. You can drag it down here. Okay, the only problem is if you drag it down here, see that little playhead there, the blue thing? If you drag it there, it kind of starts way out here. So it doesn't start till I get... So you've either got to drag it down here, just make sure it's at the beginning, or just drag it into the center bit here, okay, and it just goes in right at the beginning. So a couple of things I would like to do is I would like to create a folder in here, put all my audio in. Okay, often if I'm doing infographics, there'll be a files folder, an audio folder, a video folder, and I leave the comps just out of there. Okay, so I'm going to create this one here. This one's going to be audio. And I'm going to stick you, you, and you in there. Okay, and we're going to make a files. Files is just like any static images and any other weird stuff I get. Okay, and you notice when you create a new one, let's put it inside of files. We can fix that. This one's going to be any video. This project's not going to actually have some, but let's get some good etiquette going early on. So I'm going to twirl that up. So that's my files. Okay, one of the other things is if I hit play now, okay, you can see that they're all kind of battling it out. Okay, the voiceover here, the value of sleep, is at the same level as the music, but they kind of fight it out when I start talking. So I'm going to lower the volume of this music. Okay, so with it selected here, I'm going to do the opposite of what I did with the voiceover and lower it down. How low? Just keep dropping it down until... That feels good. Okay, so just keep lowering it down until you feel like... Yeah, that works for me. Okay, so low as you go, it's really just a balance with that... whatever has to be the highest, which is going to be our dialogue. So I'm going to lock these two here so we don't mess around with them, and we're going to move on to the next video. Hey there, what'd you think? If you like the video, hit the like button, that'd be great. Also consider subscribing to my channel. Now this is a free part of a longer course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site is a free downloadable printable PDF cheat sheet. Okay, to help you with your infographics and data visualization. Also on that site is a bunch of other courses as well. So go check it out, bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye now.